I'm not Father Tom Duggan, your new associate. I'm Father Jim Garneau, but delighted to be here and serving in a small way today. And I thank you for your good witness. The patterns of our lives have been upended tremendously, and the Sunday Mass routine, which was part of many people's lives, was uprooted, and you obviously are making efforts to keep this foundation stone in place in your own lives and your own family lives in many cases. And I thank you for that witness. It is a good and beautiful thing that you're able to do today and that you've chosen to do. And it strengthens my faith, and may it strengthen the faith of each one here as well. But of course, we know that there's a great number of people who might be at this Mass and other Masses who can't be or are still afraid to be or think it's imprudent. And without any judgment of that choice, which is theirs freely to make and blessed by the bishops in terms of the dispensation granted, I do recognize your sacrifice, but also ask the question, so what does it mean to keep the Lord's Day when there's no Sunday Mass? I'm a church historian, and for most of the history of this diocese, of this church in North Carolina, especially Eastern North Carolina, for certainly throughout the 19th century and throughout much of the 20th century even, there was no expectation by Catholics of a weekly Sunday Mass, because there simply weren't enough priests. There were very few Catholics in Eastern North Carolina, and the priests that were here were circuit riders. And there was no chance, without highways and roads, of a priest being and covering in all the missions and chapels of Eastern North Carolina on a given Sunday. And so if you were lucky, you might have Mass once a month. And then in the earliest days, Mass once every few years was the expectation. It was in 1820, 200 years ago this year, that the first bishop was sent to establish a diocese. And the diocese was Charleston, South Carolina. And that bishop included the supervision of Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina. The three states were one diocese. And so there was no expectation that you would see your bishop regularly. And so his journeys were an attempt to strengthen the faith of the people who still called themselves Catholic, who hadn't abandoned the faith or lost the faith, and to strengthen their faith. And he couldn't promise them that there would be a priest the next Sunday after his visit. There might not be a priest for years. So how do you keep holy the Lord's Day? For we don't know what will happen. I don't mean to scare anyone. We've had enough scares. But we don't know what the next fortunes will be, what the next process will be, what the next reality will be. How will you and I keep holy the Sabbath, the Lord's Day? For whether there's Mass or not, it's the Lord's Day. Whether there's Mass or not, it's the day that we celebrate the resurrection. How do you keep that holy? And if you're not well next week, or if things change and the pastors, the priests are sick and there's no Mass offered, how will you keep holy the Lord's Day? I invite you to consider that and to be practical about it and to begin to implement it, whether you can come to Mass or not. Maybe for many of us as Catholics, simply going to Mass was how we kept holy the Lord's Day. Now, that's a fundamental way, and it's a most beautiful way, and it is the right way. But even was that sufficient? Or had we gathered into a kind of mode, I went to Mass, and now I can do whatever I want? I went to Mass, now I can go shopping. I went to Mass, now I can do the work that I didn't do during the week, I can catch up. I went to Mass, I've already prayed. I've went to Mass, I don't have to think about service to the poor. I went to Mass, and so I'm covered. Maybe in these days, it's an opportunity for us to consider, how do I sanctify Sunday? How do I allow Sunday to transform me? And how do I transform Sunday? So it's not another day. So it is the day for the Christians. It is the day for Catholics. How do I inculcate that into the lives of children? Adult children who are living with me, or little children over whom you have the very deep and beautiful responsibility of being shepherds and shepherdesses over your little sheep? And how do we do that in a way that's not artificial and not bizarre? It's not a question of sitting down the kids and not allowing them to go play and telling them this is God's day. We're going to pray the rosary 43 times today. But do we pray the rosary at all today? Or does this cover it? We've taken care of God. We've finished our prayers. I said those in the morning. So I don't have an absolute plan for each one of us, but what do we do and how do we do it? And whether we have Mass or not, how is the Lord's Day kept in our hearts and in our lives? Or are we simply going through the motions? And even in coming back to Mass, are we simply trying to regroup habits that didn't include a real conversion of heart? Is every Sunday a time for God to convert my heart and my soul back to Him?